From JBS Studios in Greater New York, this is the JBS News Update with Teisha Bader.
I'm Teisha Bader with the JBS News Update for Friday, October the 29th, 2021. Israeli Prime Minister Naftali Bennett and Energy Minister Karine El-Harar announced today that Israel is pledging to be carbon neutral by the year 2050. Bennett said today the climate crisis affects all of our lives, including those of our children and grandchildren. With the new goal, Bennett said, Israel is lining up alongside the developed countries that are already taking action to attain the goal of zero emissions. Bennett will depart Israel on Sunday for the United Nations COP26 Climate Change Conference in Glasgow, Scotland, joined by El-Harar and by Israel's Minister of Environmental Protection, Tamar Zandberg. Part of a 120-people-strong delegation to the global gathering from Israel, which will also include leading figures in academia, the business sector, and civil society. Bennett's office said yesterday that he will hold meetings with a number of world leaders while at the conference, including with UK Prime Minister Boris Johnson, India's Prime Minister Narendra Modi, French President Emmanuel Macron, and Canadian Prime Minister Justin Trudeau, the first time meeting those leaders as premier. Well, an oral COVID-19 vaccine created in Israel is going to start clinical trials next month. Oramed Pharmaceuticals, based in Jerusalem, said today that they received clearance from the South African Health Products Regulatory Authority to begin the trials there for the Oravax pill. CEO Nadav Kidron said, "We believe that Oravax's oral COVID-19 vaccine candidate could offer an exciting potential solution to the COVID pandemic, whether as a booster or for the unvaccinated. An oral COVID-19 vaccine," he said, "would eliminate several barriers to rapid, wide-scale distribution, potentially enabling people to administer the vaccine themselves at home." A trial in Israel is also expected to begin soon. It is still waiting for approval by Israel's health ministry. Israel's Blue Flag 2021 concluded yesterday the massive air drill hosted by Israel's Air Force with the participation of the air forces of the United States, the United Kingdom, India, Greece, France, Italy, and Germany. The IDF shared video with remarks from IDF International spokesperson Lieutenant Colonel Amnon Scheffler explaining the significance of the international exercise.
Training alongside our allies promotes Israel's security and our mutual interest of maintaining stability in the Middle East.
17,000 people took part in the 10th annual Jerusalem Marathon this morning, including the city's mayor, Moshe Leon. The event is made up of 6 races, including a full marathon, a half marathon, and a family race. Runners could be seen throughout the morning today, making their way past the walls of the old city and through the streets of the capital. The full marathon winners were 29-year-old Yamar Geton for the men with the fastest time, and for the women, 45-year-old Anna Price. People around the world tweeted their photos today of where they are spending Shabbat in an initiative of the AGJC, the Association of Gulf Jewish Communities, an organization founded just this year for the Jewish communities from the region like Bahrain and the United Arab Emirates who are developing Jewish life there. Photos shared for this virtual Shabbat using the Shabbat with AGJC hashtag included one taken at the marathon in Jerusalem today, capturing the image of the winner, as well as photos from Bahrain and the Emirates, Hong Kong, Israel, and the U.S., where one post was from Kahal Kadosh Beit Elohim in Charleston, South Carolina, one of the oldest synagogues in the nation. Taking a look now at our programming for tonight on JBS for Friday, October the 29th, live Shabbat services are coming up at 6 o'clock from New York City's Central Synagogue, followed by Shabbat services from the Hampton Synagogue. At 8:30, it's David Broza in concert. At 9, it's the film The Wordmaker, telling the dramatic life story of Eliezer Ben-Yehuda, who championed the cause of modern Hebrew. At 10:30, a replay from the Hampton Synagogue services, followed by a replay from Central Synagogue. And coming up next, a look at this week's Torah portion. And that's the JBS News Update for Friday, October the 29th, 2021. I'm Teisha Bader. Stay healthy, stay well, and Shabbat Shalom.